April started off with a bang with the SAP Build Developer Challenge, a set of 5 puzzles involving SAP Build Apps and SAP Build Process Automation. Each puzzle involves a key feature of the tool. So for example, the first one, released this week, requires you to write a short formula to transform and aggregate some data. If you get it right, you'll get a hint to a famous kids movie in the resulting data. We'll have challenges on OData, on automation bots, on business processes, as well as UI design. So go see my blog with details on how to enter and make sure you participate.
Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. So I'm finally back home after going on the road for the SAP CoGen Roadshow. And when I got back, I found a new mission in the SAP Discovery Center called Getting Started with SAP S/4HANA Cloud ABAP Environment. Taking a glance at the project board, we can see this mission takes us through the various steps around how to get started with extending SAP S/4HANA Cloud applications, including some introductory slides, links to other resources, demos, and if you have access to a licensed SAP S/4HANA Cloud system, then of course there are some great tutorials to go through as well. So have fun with that. And while we're on the subject of ABAP, last week, Olga from ABAP Product Management posted a blog post called Make Use of ABAP Cloud Development in the ABAP Development Tools for Eclipse. In her blog post, she talks about how ABAP Development Tools offers various capabilities to support development tasks with ABAP Cloud, like switching the ABAP language version to cloud development, finding out if an object is released for cloud development, looking for released objects in the system, and releasing custom objects for usage within ABAP Cloud Development, and of course, much, much more. For more information, please check out Olga's blog post.
Hey, developers. The report covering the results of the 2023 SAP Developer Insight Survey is out as of earlier this week. We asked some repeat questions from past years to track trends, and if you took the survey back in February, you'll remember some new questions this year, digging into popular programming frameworks, popular IDEs, and even open source contribution. It's all in the report. There's a link to the report below. Check it out at the end of the news and post your questions and thoughts below too. Thank you.
We at SAP are pleased to announce that SAP HANA 2.0 Service Pack Stack 07 is now generally available. This SPS has a variety of new and important capabilities. It simplifies the in-memory computing environment and introduces numerous features that contribute to a lower TCO, improved scalability, and enhanced user experience. In this new service pack, developers will find modeling enhancements, updated XSA runtimes, enhanced machine learning capabilities, and improved and seamless data federation and replication capabilities. You can check all the new and improved features in the What's New section of the documentation. But we as well invite you to join the live stream series where you learn about the latest SAP HANA innovations directly from product experts. These streams will be on our SAP Developers channel. As well, the new release of SAP HANA Cloud was made available last weekend. Developers should find some new capabilities in QRC 1 2023, like new features in calculation view modeling, new automated machine learning pipeline explainability, TypeScript support for the SAP HANA Node.js driver, materialized views with incremental refresh functionality in the relational engine of SAP HANA Cloud, Data Lake. More details in blog posts published by the product management. In the end, I personally would like to thank everyone who joined the last month's developer challenge, exploring data with SAP HANA Cloud and Python. I was very pleased to read your feedback. No worries if you missed it. The content of the challenge is still available for everyone, but now along with solutions.
There are a couple of recent monthly releases from March to which we would like to draw your attention. First, there's the March 2023 release for the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, that's CAP to you and me, with plenty for us to discover and explore. Just to get a few highlights into this news item, there are some new beta features, such as calculated elements, which allow you to specify elements with a calculation expression. There's a completely rebuilt SQLite database service that brings about more features and improved performance. And there's support for draft-enabled entities already, but that's been now much improved, redesigned to bring more intuitive handler registrations and also to make a clearer distinction for request targets. There's also a new CAP security guide, a new CDS plugin technique, and lots more. Read all about it in the usual place on the CAPHIRE website. There's also plenty to discover and explore in the March 2023 release for the SAP Build Process Automation. Here are just a few of highlights from that release. First, in the area of process forms and UI, you can now add a timed wait step to a process. You can have your users receive and work on tasks in the SAP Task Center through a new integration. And you can also customize the outcome button in approval and submission forms and set the button, for example, to have a text with a value that makes more sense to you and your users. In the area of process orchestration and automation, you can add now API triggers directly to your automation, and these will get exported with your project. This will save you time later on, manual effort post-deployment. There are also enhancements to the template creation process for document information extraction. And last but certainly not least, there's a new SAP Build content catalog available with pre-built process automations and application templates and other processes for you to get started with. In fact, there's a lot more updates in this release, so be sure to check out the blog post from Engsel for all the details.